Well, there is Jason Richardson warming up for the hurdles. And the British athletes as well warming up too. But now the first heat of the first round of the men's 110-metre hurdles. And once again, it's always difficult. 10 barriers, 3 strides between them. Darren Robles is here. We don't know what sort of form he's in. Yu Zhang is here as well. Holds the Olympic record when he set when he won the Olympic gold in 2004. There's the lineup. In lane 2, the Vidalis of Greece, then Villar of Colombia, Darien of France, Ilariani of Georgia, Buller of Germany, Shidong Peng of the People's Republic of China, Degelt of Belgium, and Shubenkov of Russia. That's Darien, the Frenchman, 13.15, European silver medalist this year. It's only the first through to go, three to go through, plus the 6 fastest losers to tomorrow's semi-final. Now Shubenkov, the European champion, I tell you, he was very impressive at 13.09, winning the European Championship, and then went to Monaco and equaled that record at 13.09. He is a real talent, and he could so easily get even closer to 13 flat. So the first heat then, first 3 to go through. Shubenkov should qualify. Nice little look and a smile, very relaxed. Disguises a nervousness, I would think.
Set.
Well, Shubenkov going well, so is Darien, and so is Villar of Colombia on the far side. Shubenkov and Darien. And right on the far side, Vidalis of Greece going very strong, but Shubenkov coming through to take this. Vidalis of Greece is in second place, and will work out third in a moment. But 13.28, very, very comfortable indeed by Shubenkov. And also, of course, Vidalis of Greece ran well too. But Shubenkov, 13.26, well within himself there, looked very comfortable, very easy. And I tell you what, the Greek has got a best of 13.37, is running pretty well to that sort of form. And I just wonder whether Darien did get to third, we'll see.
No, it's Degelt who got third, just ahead of Darien, very close, just 0.02. But Shubenkov is a real new talent, isn't he, the Russian hero, very impressive in the European Championships. And Duvalidis just getting within 0.03 of his own Greek record there. And you see, it's Degelt of Belgium who just gets that third place ahead of Darien, separated by several lanes there, of course.
Yeah, very good finish indeed. And Shubenkov looks so easy, doesn't he, on the near side. He's a real... I can see. And we've got it. It's the line. But Shubenkov looked very confident, didn't he?
Well, now we have the second heat of the men's 110-metre hurdles. And this features the reigning world champion, Jason Richardson, of the United States of America, who goes here in lane 2. This is Richardson, fine form this year again. Indeed, he's moved on from that world gold medal, which is a slight surprise, to now be one of the elite sub-13-second men. He's run 12.98 this season. It's Jason Richardson there. So he's the third fastest in the world this year, did that time in the US Olympic trials. Here's Lawrence Clark, the up-and-coming youngster from Britain. From European junior champion, Commonwealth bronze medalist, and the crowd respond as they always do here in the stadium. Absolutely packed, and they support all the British athletes. This is one of the top young talents. Andrew Riley from Jamaica won the American collegiate double at both 100 metres on the flat and the 110 metre hurdles. So it's Forbes of the Cayman Islands, Richardson, USA, Lynchia, Belarus, Lanos, Puerto Rico, Almeida, Portugal, Clark, Great Britain, Davis of Trinidad, Asghari of Iran, and Riley of Jamaica in this, the second heat. So Richardson in 2, Riley in 9, Clark in 6, those we've identified. There's also Wayne Davis of Trinidad, world junior and youth record holder.
set.
Well, the red vest in his field, and Richardson is certainly well away. He's up with Lyncher outside him, and away he comes from the rest of the field. The battle is on behind him. Lyncher continuing to go very well. So too Lawrence Clark coming through, the British athlete. Clark can see that, and he's just got second place just ahead of Llanos of Puerto Rico. And Jason Richardson, well, first sight of him, not particularly quick, 13.33, but the job done. Wind slightly behind the athletes, 0.8 metres per second. But a tidy enough one by Richardson, with Lawrence Clark just come up confirmed on the giant scoreboard, and the crowd roar. He's got pretty close to his best, running 13.42. And Lyncher, the Belarus athlete, was always going very well indeed. Good start, and he came through to take third place.
Yeah, actually, Lyncher was slightly ahead of Richardson at the start, and he got the best start of all. But Richardson, once he got into his stride, is very much a class act. But it's very well done for Lawrence Clark, the young Briton, who's really developing fast and furious, overtakes Lyncher in the final stages to take second place. With the first three to go through by right, then that's a very good qualification. I love the technique of Richardson. He's got such a good trail leg, and that lead leg straight out, and it comes down so quickly because the trail leg pulls through so fast. I mean, he is definitely a prospect as the world champion, and still in very good form. In fact, he's in better form, as Peter said, than he was last year. He's broken 13 seconds, and he's got the warmers on, as you can see, just taking no chances at all. Well, Deron Robles, the world champion. We haven't seen much of him. The Olympic champion, who was disqualified in the end for pulling Liu Zhang back in Daegu and got disqualified, but he is an Olympic champion, of course. So we now move on to heat three of the men's hurdles. There's the lineup for you. In lane one, Sands, Bahamas, Dakuri, France in two, Kami, Madagascar, three, Ortega of Cuba in four, Pozzi of Great Britain in five, Shabanov, Russia, six, Thomas, Trinidad and Tobago, seven, Parchment, Jamaica, eight, and Ballonweight of Germany in lane nine. Well, Ladji Dakuri, world champion in 2005, 13.37 this year, his best back in 2005 of 12.97. Ortega's the Cuba that has beaten Robles this year, and the Cubans have often brought along the hurdlers in the past, but he's got a best of 13.09 this season too, so he should feature. And so should Henry Parchment of Jamaica, joining the eighth lane. He's got a 13.18. But there's Pozzi, a very, very good prospect for British hurdling, along with Lawrence Clark. These two youngsters have come through the junior ranks well, savouring this moment. That's a nervous smile, and so it may be. There's Hansi Parchment, the World Student Games champion last year, 13.18. Student of psychology, and that always helps when you're in this sort of situation. So the first three to go through, plus the sixth fastest to the final. That's Ortega. Their own little ritual, isn't it? Each time they go down. Well, that's Kame of Madagascar, and he's a 14.6 man, and he's gone. He needed all the start he could get to actually start to compete in this race, but he no longer takes part in it because they'll go and bring that big red marker in front of him very shortly, I think. It's a shame, really, because he's the record holder. He's a decathlete, actually. And he's used to being able to have one false start because the decathlon rules are slightly different. Here it comes, there it is. And the crowd go, ah. But that's the rule. And that's the rule. And he's gone. It's a strict one false start and you're out rule. Great shame for the young man.
On your marks.
Sands and Dakuri, Ortega, Putzi, Shabanov, Thomas, Parchment, and Belnoweit of Germany on the near side. It's the man nearest to us in lane nine.
Set.
this time, and Shubenkov got away well, and Parchment going strong at the moment. Right on the inside is Sands going very well, and also the Cuban Ortega, and it's going with the form book, isn't it? Ortega wins it, and second place is Parchment.
Well, except for the two who fell, I'm afraid, in that race. Andrew Pozzi, the highly touted British athlete, crashed out very early in the race, and then later on, Shamar Sands crashed out as well.
Yeah, but it, you know, the two qualifiers, that's the important thing. We'll pick up the third in a moment. And there are all sorts of problems in that race, but nevertheless, Ortega and Parchment were the class act. And we'll see what happens. Great shame for Pozzi. Let's catch up with this now. Pozzi doesn't get away particularly well here. I must admit, he's obviously got an injury. I think he's injured, because he certainly did not look as though he was attacking the hurdle. Let's look at Sands now in lane one. He was leading at that stage. He goes down there. But my eye on Ortega, really. Ortega and Parchment on the near side. And with Shabanov just sneaking through ahead of Decori into third place. But no doubt about the two. Sands goes out, yes. But Ortega, this is about qualification. And the Cuban, who's shaped up well this season, 13:26, same as the first heat, and he's a good technician, but Parchment looked a little better, actually, despite coming in second. But that was full of incident, wasn't it, fallers? But I have to say that Putzi, I'm not sure that he's fit, because that is not the Putzi that I know.
Well, there is the lineup for Heat 4, and as Stuart's just mentioned, Darren Robles, the world record holder, defending champion, going in lane 9, right on the outside. And the other major talent in this race is Jeff Porter, the American, who has been a consistent runner for some years and really excelled at the US Olympic trials. So here is Porter, who moved his personal best down from 13:26 to 13:08 to take his place on the US team. And that really is tough, because there's such depth of talent and high hurdling in the US. Darren Robles, little question marks, of course, big question marks over his state of fitness, state of form this year. A huge talent, set the world record at 12:87 in Ostrava a few years back, and he's been hugely prominent for a long time now.
On your mark.
And he goes in the outside lane, Swift of Barbados, Porter, USA, Hazza of Lebanon, Fouri, South Africa, Al-Shamari, Kuwait, John, Germany, Bascu of France, Cotto of Puerto Rico, and Robles of Cuba. Heat 4 of the 110-meter hurdles. Robles in 9, Porter in 2, the two favourites. No problems, good spot by Greg Marsh-Swift on the inside, and now Porter's getting into his running, but here's Robles on the inside, smoothly coming through, problem inside him, but Robles is not looking as sharp as he sometimes does, but nonetheless, it's enough to win this race. Fouri dips hard, crashes to the crowd, to the ground afterwards, and Porter got third place there, so that's the 1-2-3, sure of going through. 13:33 the winning time.
Yeah, he's obviously lacking races, because he hasn't had enough races coming into a major champion. I think Fouri may well have got into second place there, but we'll get that confirmed in a minute. I thought he'd got second. But let's have another look at this. Robles on the left of your shot. He's got a 7 strides to the first hurdle, which is very good. Swift gets away well, and Fouri of South Africa running well at this stage. But on the near side, Robles, he's quick, he does come off the hurdle quick, he's got a terrific trail leg, and in the end he runs away with it, but third place was Jeff Porter, he'll be the third qualifier. Not convincing at all, but then you can't tell. The next round is the one I'll be able to tell from. He looked very easy in the end, but just lacking a little bit of edge that we normally associate with him as an Olympic champion, but he has had lots of injuries.
And the other one who's got through all right, Jeff Porter, was some way below the sort of form he showed in the US trials.
Heat 5 then of the men's hurdles. And there's the lineup: Abate of Italy, Xi of China, Braithwaite of Barbados, Bennett of Honduras, Kiss of Hungary, Merritt, Aries Merritt of the United States, Jumis of Haiti, and Phillips of Jamaica. Abate, the Italian, for the best of 13:28 this season. which equates to a personal best. Mr. Xi of China. Ryan Braithwaite, of course, in Berlin, became his country's first ever world champion or world championship medalist in athletics. That was back in 2009 in Berlin, but here's the man of the moment. His last three races, under 13 seconds. Aries Merritt of the United States, new world indoor champion, and 12.93 this season. And if anyone is, he's just changed his stride pattern from the blocks to the first hurdle, from 8 to 7 strides, and it's made such a difference to him. His touchdowns at 3 and 5 hurdles are much improved, and that is shown in the way in which he's run. He should win this convincingly. He's so sharp. He really is, unless, of course, anything goes wrong. Things can go wrong, you know, with these 10 3-foot-6 barriers. It's very difficult. But the first three to go through by right. But we'll have a look and see what sort of form Merritt's in. Looking forward to the final. The Italian Abati in the inside, and Braithwaite. Couple of athletes away from him.
Oh, stand up, gentlemen, please. Stand up and line up immediately again. Thank you.
He's asking. Alan is not happy. I'll try and get the binoculars on him and see whether he's got a... I'm not sure what happened there. He was remonstrating with the official.
Lim Wong, do you understand?
No, nothing obvious. No. I'm wondering if they've gone on the blocks, but they haven't adjusted them.
Let me remind you of the lineup for this fifth heat of the first round of the men's high hurdles. Abati, Italy in 1, Xi of China in 2, Braithwaite, Barbados 3, Bennett, Honduras 4, Kiss, Hungary 5, Merritt, the United States in the next lane, then Junis and then Phillips. And running from lanes 2, other 1 to 9.
Set.
Well, Merritt already away from this field, Braithwaite going well too, and she of China going well. Look at Merritt, he's so quick off the hurdle with Braithwaite coming through very strongly behind him, and Braithwaite gets there in second place. But that 13.07, and that was with such ease. Oh, he's in such good form, terrific form he is, and you've got to say that last season he started off so well and then petered out as it came to the World Championships, but since then, my goodness me, he's virtually unbeatable. 13.07, the season's best for Braithwaite actually at 13.23. He ran quite well in that, I thought.
Ran very well indeed, and Xi of China just getting the third place on the inside there in lane 3. He was always away well, but this was a wonderful demonstration of hurdling by Merritt. He's certainly looking the best so far, although these early stages, of course.
Look how he's having to cut his stride in the middle, and that's a good sign. It really means he's really going so quickly, and he saunters through. He's definitely going to... I tell you what, if the conditions are good, he could break the world record here. He could. I'm very impressed with him. We'll see what sort of form Liu Zhang's in, though, because the Chinese athlete is so very formidable. So the Xi of China came through to take that third place. So he did at 13.43. It was a big margin, though.
Yes, but good times also for fourth and fifth, Abate and Phillips. They're running 13.4 times, and that will take them through to the next round as well.
Yeah.
Fascinating to see how Yu Shang shapes up. Merritt has looked the best of the rivals at the moment. And of course, this 110-meter hurdles has, throughout this year, been one of the most keenly anticipated events in the Olympic athletics program. Those are the men at the moment who are in the next six qualifiers. As I said, Abati and Phillips from that previous race looked sure of going through with their 13.46 and 13.47, respectively. So here is the lineup. We have Dembele of Senegal, Shane Brathwaite of Barbados, the younger brother of Ryan, who we've just seen run so well, Baji of Hungary, Liu of China, Noga of Poland, Kinoneth of Spain, Turner, Great Britain, Sudok, Netherlands, and Nuruddin of Nigeria. So Noga of Poland in the middle of the screen there, former world junior champion and bronze medalist in the recent European Championships in Helsinki, coming back to the sort of form and potential he showed as a junior. Back view there of Shane Brathwaite of Barbados, who's run 13.31. But now introduced to the crowd is Liu Shang, Olympic champion of 2004, wonderful record at the high hurdles, third, second, first and second in the last four world championships, and a real superstar in China. Noga, who I mentioned before, the Polish athlete who's got a best of 13.27. And plenty of interest, of course, in the crowd. Just listen to Roar when he's introduced. A great favourite, Andrew Turner. European and Commonwealth bronze in 06, and then he came through to win the Commonwealth title in New Delhi in 2010, and of course got the world bronze medal last year. Been struggling for full fitness this year, and let's hope he's in good shape for the British supporters here today.
On your mark.
A great deal of interest in Liu Shang, having seen Robles, having seen Richardson, having seen Merritt all win their heat, and Liu, one of the favourites along with those men. Dembele, Brathwaite, Baji, Liu, Noga, Kinoneth, Turner, Sedok and Nuruddin. Sedok, the Dutchman, always a very fast starter, from a European indoor champion. He goes in eight.
Set.
Well, Liu's away, brilliant. He's leaving the other side. Oh, he's fallen though. Oh, he got a such a start in the way. Well, we'll come back to that in a moment. Meanwhile, it's Andy Turner of Great Britain who's heading the field with Nuruddin of Nigeria. And it is Turner who takes it from Nuruddin and Sedok. Well, tragedy again for Liu Shang. He got away, perhaps almost too quickly, Stuart. We'll have a look at the replay, yeah, obviously, in that, yeah, race.
I think he was holding his Achilles. And I think he is there. He's holding his Achilles, and I think he may well have an injury as well. But that is a big shock, and I do mean a big shock. It happened. He didn't get away in the last Olympics. Let's look at this again. If I can get a head-on shot, seven strides, hits it with his lead leg. You can't do that. You cannot do that. And once you hit it with your lead leg, with your lead foot, you're gone. And he's injured himself at the same time. He's avoided the wheelchair. He's just hopped off, as you can see. And that is a very sad exit indeed. He hit the hurdle with his lead leg. He's changed to seven strides. Didn't look sharp to get to the first hurdle. He didn't. And he didn't get the lead leg up high enough. And striking with the lead foot, 99 times out of 100, you will not survive. You will not survive. He's coming down to say, I wonder if he's trying to say that he's finished. Because he didn't get into the games last time.
Yeah, looks like it.
Just wants to get some sort of time, although you've got to go over the hurdles, I have to say. He wanted to get to the last hurdle. That's what he wanted to do, just to say, well, as a former Olympic champion, that's a very sad, sad situation. He's helped off now by the Hungarian, and really, that Badji is helping him.
They're all coming round to help a man who's been a great, great athlete, and this may well be Liu Shang bowing out of the athletics arena. So sad, after he would have wanted to do so well in Beijing, came here, good time earlier the year, but obviously wasn't right, and sadly, this is it again. This is, yep, Liu Shang in lane four.
Watch the lead leg. Watch, he hits it with his lead foot there. Right. As soon as that happens, and his ankle went as well once he got over that hurdle. And look, there's another faller as well. That's Braithwaite.
And Noga didn't get going at all.
Well, they were all over the place in that heat. Well, he hurt himself coming off that hurdle. It's clearly, yep, he is fit, and hit that lead hurdle, and eventually he's taken the chair. Well, that's so sad. Two Olympics in a row. He has been an Olympic champion, one in 2004, but my goodness me, how unlucky is that? But he crashed out. And that is the one thing you cannot do. We'll have another look at it now. The seven strides, and look at that. He's gone down so heavily in his ankle, you could see. And Braithwaite went as well. And he gets away so quickly here. And then he's changed from 8 to 7. He was managing it very, very well, I have to say. He managed to change very quickly, but it does mean you've got to stretch a bit, and he didn't get to the hurdle. He didn't. If you hit it with your trail leg, you're okay. You're all right on that, but you cannot possibly do get away with this. Watch it again. Heel there, onto it, slides off the hurdle, down he goes, nothing you can do. I don't know any hurdler in the world that would survive that, not one.
Well, a roar from the crowd. They appreciate seeing a great champion, no doubt about that, but it's very, very sad. An incident-packed series of hurdles races.
Oh, goodness me, but what a good run indeed by Andy Turner there. It was a very good run indeed, wasn't it? And
Nuruddin and Sedok also going through. But Noga not getting to the first hurdle. Brathwaite crashing out, and Liu too.
An incredibly eventful occasion, wasn't it? Now the semi-finals then, Merritt, Braithwaite, Ortega, Shubenkov, Parchment, Richardson, Robles, and Devaladis, Clark, Turner, Xi, Abate, Linsha, Phillips, Foure, and Nuruddin. And you can see the small queues on there are the fastest qualifiers. We've got an example at the top, Wayne Davis, and also Darien, and Villa, and Bascu, and Shabanov. So there you have it. That's the lineup for the semi-finals. And a great loss for Liu Zhang,